even though graffiti in Latin is vandalism, it doesn't have to be vandalism, you know, it can, you know, people put a lot of time and effort into it, and should, you know, some people don't realize that and give it the right respect.
Fresh Kid Z, Fresh Kid C,
yes, sir.
Fresh Kid P, Fresh Kid T.
Oh yeah, we back.
Oh, and Zafoon, by the way.
Yeah, Jones. Yeah. Chitty Bang, and we pretty much amazing.
Can we hear your new song, please?
I got you.
Hey yo, I once was a kid, all I had was a dream. More money, more problems, when I get it, I'ma pile it up. Now I'm dope, want the bread, we can toast. So fresh, how we flow, everybody get this down
hey,
from
yo,
us.
I once was a kid with the other little kids. Now I'm ripping up shows and them fans going wild with us. Tell mommy I'm sorry, this life is a party. I'm never growing up.
Feeding is to me, means to me like a form. It's a form of communication. It's a form of expression. It's a form of emotion. Definitely, like how I'm feeling will really dictate how my work turns out. So, if I'm like really creative one day, or like have a lot of ideas, you know, sometimes like thinking about different things. If my life's really stressful, if my work becomes pretty creative. Like really, really intricate, because like that's kind of my way of putting that stress on paper and getting rid of it.
I was essentially hooked almost the first time I ever picked up a spray can and realized that from now on, I didn't have to ask. I didn't have to think about whether or not I could get this piece into the show at school or get this painting into the gallery. I didn't have to worry about whether I was ever going to be good enough. I could just go out and do it and be guaranteed that somebody was
going to
see it.
My name is Kiatsu. I'm a graffiti vandal from the United States. I have my name Katsu. I also use a single stroke skull as my tag and throw up. Graffiti is not art. Graffiti is about promoting crimes that disrupt the look of the city.
Yeah, I just want to say I'm proud to like not have to be here with my mask on like Katsu, and my voice changed, and I'm not afraid or ashamed to say that I write graffiti where for years, like people that knew me really well are like, when I finally started painting, they're like, you write graffiti? Like, yeah, like, I would never guess that about you. And that was always sort of part of my Clark Kent Superman capes thing. Was like, yeah, I went with this real clean cut, presentable image, wore a shirt and tie at my job for years. But now I'm proud to stand here, talk to you about it, be open about it, continue that dialogue, make art in public space, and hopefully continue the discussion, continue the art form.
Yes. There's a kiss, diagnostic.
Yo, you might hear me making record like Wilson, cause I love summer, no Rachel Bilson.
Yes.
The winter will come, we just have parties inside, it's still fun.
We're jamming,
pump this,
we're banging.
Chase your boyfriend, let's have him. We're rowdy, girls make our judgment cloudy. But when the sun comes out, we're still alkies. We don't wanna be lousy or shameless, but we're running around like we're brainless. Now I got grass stains on my brand new white trainers.
On my brand new white trainers.
I know a few guys, haters, steppers, competitors, neighbors, so laters, it's blaters, we've got our own sound, you know now, so go wild and get hosed down, and oh no,
yeah, yeah.
Let's get down with the trumpets,
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 yeah, yeah.
Let's get down with the down with the,
what?
Let's get down with the down with the,
yeah, yeah.
Let's get down with the trumpets,
when I get down, I get
any kind of art is very subjective. Just because it's public, illegal, or legal, I think it just depends on your taste and the skills that are shown by the artist. We actually had a piece of public art that was meaningful to the studio and important, and someone tagged it, and so it had to be painted over. So it was I found that very disrespectful to that artwork in our public space. But there's also something to be said with someone trying to have space for creativity.
Graffiti writers should love graffiti. People in the public should hate it.
Yeah, I think it's a lot of misperception, really, you know, like you see a tagged building in a city and then you see a broken window in a city and so on and so forth, and you think that it's like this condemnation of a space, but it's only that when it's forced to be quick and scared and trying to get away all the time. When you give a kid the opportunity to paint, or you give a middle-aged man the opportunity to paint and feel comfortable and not be afraid, then it's gonna come out a lot different, and it's gonna be less about like vandalism and destruction, and it's gonna be a lot more about beautification. And I would think that we all want that.
Well, I think that desire to vandalize partially comes from that stigma from society. Like, we're not gonna recognize you, you're not a valuable part of our community, we don't want you in this. So instead of saying, oh, here's a free wall, let's see what you've got, express yourself, and like encouraging that, they take it in the opposite direction. They're like, oh, well, fine, I'm gonna do what I want and where I want. And it's like that, don't tell me what not to do, mom, because I'm gonna go do exactly the opposite.
Some kids do it because they're angry, they told me, you know, and like that's a way of getting back at society or getting back at other people. They also do it because they like that scene, that underground scene, you know, like not having anybody know who you are. It's pretty neat. So it's like a fame, you know, you're technically famous, but nobody knows who you are. Some people just do it to do it, you know, they don't have any walls, they want to paint, so they do it for that. Sometimes they just want to be that kid who does it illegally, you know, it's like that's what they think, you know, cool is or something like that. I personally don't like it because it doesn't get you anywhere, you know, like, you know, it's expensive to buy paint in the first place, so if you're doing it illegally, there's always a chance that it's going to get covered up the next day or within a few hours, you know. I know kids who have done pieces and 3 hours later they're already gone. You know, two people who have to see them driving by.
I guess the only thing I fear when I meet young artists, young writers, is like, there's so much ego. There's so much, like, that piece gets clung to pretty hard in graffiti culture, in hip hop culture in general. The sort of like, you know, if you go to an MC battle and watch kids battle each other, it's not about who's the best, it's about who can diss the other guy more. If you go to a DJ battle, it's about like making the other DJ look stupid in some way. It's not about just how good you are and how much you love what you're doing. And I think that I would love to see, and I think that's why we've like connected with young artists sometimes, is that opportunity to give them that one message, that one lesson of, it's not about anybody else. It's about you and what you choose to do and how you choose to do it. And don't let anybody tell you you're good, bad, or otherwise. And don't worry about how you compare to everybody else. Just do your thing and do it to death, you know?
I feel like we try to push a message of positivity. And like I said, there's a lot of power in graph. If you want to use it in a negative way, you could definitely go around and destroy a bunch of stuff around the city, but if you want to use it in a positive way, you could definitely inspire people too. And I just hope that the younger generation picks up on that positive message.